rather watch this lighter form of brain disease right now and then move on. Joe Rogan says that Sanjay Gupta had a poor showing on his podcast because Gupta had wrongly assumed Joe would defer to him as a medical expert, and Gupta realized that Joe is informed. Yeah, dude, that's totally what happened.
Randomly, the morning that...
Thank you, Psychedelic Gazelle and Professor Soup for the five gifteds.
That podcast came out with that CNN guy. Sanjay
Gupta?
Yeah. It popped up. I was like, oh, cool. This will be fun. And so I started listening to it. And yeah, that was a real... It was like... Again, sort of like two people were watching two different movies. Yeah. And it was weird, too, to hear him say, like, oh, you know, I listen to your podcast. I was thinking to myself, I don't know how much this guy's listened to Joe Rogan's podcast, because he kind of rolled in.
I like that Joe went from, I'm a fucking idiot. I'm a monkey. I'm an ape. Don't listen to me. Like, I'm just trying to make jokes, to like, no, actually, I'm smarter than fucking people who have, like, done the reading when I, you know, debate them. Because I've done my research, and, you know, that's my Facebook research, and it's giving me the tools to be able to debate doctors and shit on the matter.
Like, he was not prepared for what was about to go down.
I think he's insanely busy. That's what I think.
Okay.
The guy's a legitimate practicing neurosurgeon, and he works like 100 hours a week. No bullshit. Uh-huh. I mean, that guy is like legitimately dealing with real patients all the time, constantly, and then works as a consultant for CNN. So
for the first time, like, I'm noticing that Joe Rogan's tendency to fucking appeal to authority is withering away, because he has such strong convictions on this COVID thing. I don't know if it's because of like all the dumb, weird shit that he's read. I don't know if it's like a sea of sycophants that want to suckle on Joe Rogan's content teat for relevance. I don't know what it is, but ultimately it feels like this is one of the few instances where he literally believes his convictions. He's like, no, I'm right on the COVID thing. Because I talked about this on the Leftovers podcast that's coming out tomorrow. There's a lot of fun stuff on there, by the way. I don't want to tease it. There's, you know, there's some Harvey Weinstein, Ryan Kavanaugh shit on there too. I said pretty much this, where it was like, he could snap you in half. Yeah, Joe Rogan could probably beat my ass. I don't know if that makes him the foremost authority on COVID. I don't know why you would even bring that up. I it's not something I disagree with. You would stand a chance, I think. I don't fucking know, dude. Probably not. I mean, I've watched the Joe Rogan kicks like machine guns videos, you know? Seems unlikely. Joe Rogan stands some of the weirdest motherfuckers in the world. Yeah, dude. Especially because they're like older men. You know what I mean? It's not like... Like, if you're, like, a 14-year-old teenage girl, it's, like, one thing. Or if you're, like, a teenager in general, it's, like, one thing to be a stan. But if you're, like, a fucking 40-year-old guy who started doing BJJ and stuff, and, like, you're tailoring your life around what Joe Rogan would want you to do, it's kind of weird. Like, if you're a victim of divorce court, you should not be standing another human, okay? I guess they're not as psychotic or as delusional as, like, the younger teenager stans, though, you know what I mean? Like, Nicki Minaj stans are still worse than Joe Rogan stans. Maybe that's because they're, like, older dudes, for the most part, that are just, like, divorced dads who are angry. Like, I don't have Joe Rogan stans being like, we need to dox and murder this man because he said this about Joe Rogan. Whereas, like, Ariana stans are saying that. You know what I mean? As I was saying, I mentioned this in the Leftovers podcast. You'll see it tomorrow. It's going to be really good. But Joe Rogan went from, you know, talking about his friends who are divorced dads and, like, have to pay alimony and, like, talking about fucking, you know, DMT and shit in every episode to literally just having media guys on. This is, like, you know, I gave a hat tip to Felix on that one. He just has media guys on right now, right? He only has media guys on, and they all have, like, their fucking conservative talking points ready to go. But even then, Joe has like two things that he's consistently defended, or one thing that he's always consistently defended, no matter who he's fucking talking to, other than him being like a regular chameleon, right? And the thing is weed. Like, he'll debate people on weed. Like, he's like very, he has very strong convictions on weed. Now it's weed and fucking COVID. Like, he literally was trying to dunk on Dr. Rhonda Patrick, dunking on fucking Sanjay Gupta, like, whoever the fuck he has on that are, like, otherwise medical experts. Like, that's the one area where he will not be a chameleon. He will fucking debate you. And it's clear that he's, like, you know, whether it's because he's, like, too embarrassed to admit that he's wrong, or whether it's because he's, like, truly fucking brainwashed, He's just straight up weird about this COVID shit. It's crazy. I say this as like, I'm putting my, you know, I know Joe Rogan well and am a fan hat on, okay?
I think he felt like the same way. If I had a conversation with you about military tactics mm-hmm. and leadership in the SEALs, mm-hmm. I would defer to you about everything. I would just be asking questions. Yeah. You're the expert.
But when it comes to, you know, doctors about COVID, I don't defer to them because they're stupid.
I think he had this idea that that's how it was going to be. That we were going to have this conversation yeah. about COVID and medicine and a medical situation.
Yeah. Obviously, like, being in the military and knowing about military shit is way more professionalized and way higher a barrier of entry than being a fucking neurosurgeon who reads, like, medical journals and understands them and can elaborate them as, like, a communicator, you know what I mean, of medical journals. Like, literally, that's his job, other than being a fucking neurosurgeon, is to make medical information, process medical information from journals and, like, communicate them to the public, which is, of course, significantly easier, duh, than being a fucking soldier guy who talks about soldier experiences, duh. Come on, dude. That's why I defer to you, Jocko, because you're the most thumb-like guy. You can tell me about being a thumb. Whereas, you know, when it comes to processing medical journals accurately, well, then, fucking, I got this. I got this one, Sanjay. Don't worry about it. I've read enough Facebook posts.
And then he was going to give me all this information that was right. going to straighten me out.
Ouch.
Didn't work out that
it
way.
It didn't work out
well, I've been fucking talking to scientists yeah, and yeah. doctors and biologists and virologists for months yeah, and yeah. months.
He has not. He has not done that. He has absolutely not done that. Even if he did do that, that does not make you a medical expert. No, you've only talked to people that are completely outside of that fucking field, or at the very most, edge cases that are going against the scientific consensus on purpose in an effort to become media figures, okay? He has not. He literally has not fucking talked to, like, the people that he talked to, like Michael Osterholm, right? Like, on Joe Biden's, like, COVID pandemic response team, right? That was, like, fucking 2 years ago almost at this point. Like, that's when COVID first popped off. And that's it. He had him on to talk about the fucking measures that are necessary that we need to take. And since then, he hasn't had, like, a single fucking actual medical expert on that will go against it. And when it comes to, like, Rhonda Patrick and shit, he's like, no, I don't care. Where are the epidemiologists that he's had on? Brett Weinstein is not a fucking doctor. Brett Weinstein literally is just a fucking, what is he, like a evolutionary biologist person that got fired from his university and has been, like, running off that for years about cancel culture? Stop hating Hasan. It doesn't look good. It's not hating. I just want Joe Rogan to be fucking, you know, not this, like, weirdo snake oil salesman who thinks his fucking farts smell like lavender, okay? The thing that made Joe Rogan so appealing was that he was a dude bro. He was a fucking dude bro who, like, recognizes limitations. And his, like, chameleon style actually made it really interesting for unique guests that he had on to come on and fucking talk about their shit. That's not hate, dude. I've known about Joe Rogan, have met Joe Rogan, and have been a fan of Joe Rogan before you knew who the fuck Joe Rogan was. Shut the fuck up. He's turned into this, like, fucking boomer who posts, like, literally just, like, old ass person memes on Instagram, who constantly talks about COVID every fucking episode, no matter who the fuck is on.
Months and months. Yeah. And you know,
you've got to be the amount of information that you have absorbed in the past 6 months, or maybe a year, about this. You've been tracking it. You've been talking to all these smart people. Man, that's rough to roll in and think that you're going to trump your statements.
Well, I think he thought that I wasn't really informed, but I keep a fucking file on my phone, and it's not a small file. I'm going to show you this. I have a folder on my phone called Cooties. And these are all COVID stories that I've read. I've read every one of them.
Yeah.
And I know.
Bro, this is literally old man. This is old man brain. Oh my God. Oh my fucking God. He has, like, terminal old man brain, dude. Hey, Dr. Sanjay Gupta, guess what, bitch? I mean, this is the joke. This is the meme. It's like, you know, 3,000 years of like a culmination of medical knowledge with millions of doctors, epidemiologists, virologists fucking studying carefully the fucking material that they're disseminating to the public versus a folder full of Facebook memes. Who wins? The Facebook memes every time. It's like, why did you go to school, dumbass? Why did you become a doctor? Why do you think you are an effective order of scientific information that you're supposed to explain to people? Like, why do you think you're a communicator of medical information when I got fucking Facebook memes on my side?
Not COVID stories, like anecdotal stories.
Right.
These are all like PubMed articles. These are all like peer-reviewed data studies. These are all VAERS reports. These are all like things on
VAERS reports. Bro, you've already owned yourself when you say these are VAERS reports. VAERS reports cannot be used in the same sentence as PubMed articles. And half of those fucking PubMed articles very likely are not even fucking peer-reviewed, okay? Even if they're pulled, your file doesn't know that they're pulled. But there you go. It's just like when you fucking... These are not anecdotal stories, bro. These are VAERS reports.
On myocarditis, these are all things on vaccine efficacy, how long it wanes, when it goes,
right.
You know, I mean, just like, I've been paying attention. I don't have an uninformed opinion.
Uh-huh.
I have a controversial opinion, but what else is new?
Yeah, it's just controversial, bro. No, you are uninformed. God damn, he's just a fucking nuts, dude.